Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Connect Civilian. So in this lecture we will see how to calculate the development length by LSM method as per IS code 456/2000, and also we will see the development length requirement at simple supports, okay, or anchorage length. We will also call development length as anchorage length. So the formula for the development length calculation is given as LD is equal to sigma s by 4 tau bd multiplied by die of the bar. So this is the die of the bar, so it is present in IS code 456 clause 26.2.1. you can go and check from the code also. I will show you the code also. So here is the code and the formula was given here. Okay, so this formula has been applied for the normal bars or mildly steel bars. Okay, so let's go to the topic again. So this is the die of the bar and this is the stress in bar, okay. So and as per IS code by LSM method, we have to use stress as 0.87 multiply by Fy, okay. So this value we should add for sigma s, and tau bd is our designed bound stress. Okay, so it is mentioned on clause number 26.2.1.1 IS code 456. So the table is given for mild steel in tension zone. Okay, so here is the table on page number 43. Okay, so we are going to use this value for different grades of concrete as design bond stress. Okay, and this value is for only mild steel bar in tension zone. Okay, if the bar is used in compression, then we have to increase the percentage of bond stress by 25%. Okay, so in case of deformed bar as per IS 1139/1966 and IS 1786/1977, the bond stress should be increased by 60%. So when we use the HYSD bars or deformed one, HYSD bars. Okay, so I will show you what is HYSD bar, how it looks like, and what is plane bar. So plane bar will look like simple plane bars. Okay, and our HYSD bar will look like there is a spiral bonding on the surface of the parts like this. If you go and check bar on site, so there is spiral bonding on the steel. Okay, that's so this bonding will help you to resist the slipping and also provide a good anchorage bond. So for plane bar, for HYSD bar, you don't required to give the anchorage length like this if your development length will be fulfilled by the stud bar. Okay, if assume that this is the HYSD bar, and if your development length is fulfilled by this distance only, so it will also be okay. It is 450 mm, and your beam width will be more than 450 or equal to around 450, so your stud bar will also be okay for deformed bar. But if you're using plane bar, you have to provide hook or bent. Okay, this is compulsory. And if you provide a HYSD bar, then you can go with the stud bar if it is not required. Okay, bent is generally provided in all the bar, but if LD will be accomplished by this position only, then you can also provide the stud one. Okay, if the length was not that much for LD, okay, for HYSD bars. Okay, and if you are providing hook, for plane or mild steel bar, then you have to provide the hook or bent. Okay, I will tell you what is hook and bent. Okay, so this bent, this is the hook. And if you put 90 degree cut, this is the bent. Okay, so for mild plain or mild steel bars we have to provide this. Okay, so if we are providing the bond stress for HSD bar, the bond stress should be increased by 60%, so we have to increase the formula by 1.6. okay, and if the bond stress for barring compression, so we are calculating the bond stress for compression zone, sorry, LD for compression zone, then we have to increase the bond stress by 25%. So if you increase this formula by 25%, the value will become as 0.7 fy. So 0.7 fy is sigma s. Okay, and sigma s is the stress in bar. So I will guide you the what is sigma s. So assume this is the beam, okay, and this is the bar. So if tensile force will appear, then your bar will stretch in this position like this. An opposite force will act at the surface of the steel and concrete, between the surface of steel and concrete. So this will be the stress in bars produced. So sigma s will be this, okay, opposite forces between concrete and steel when tensile force is applied on it. Okay, so now bar in compression, if the bar will be in compression, so it will increase by 25%, so value will be 3.7 fy into 5 the diameter of bar upon 5 tau bt. So we will change the value of 4 into 5, so it is increased by 25%. So if you find out the value of 4, okay, so 25% of 4 will be 1%, so it will increase by 1 value. Okay, so 5 tau bt, this is the formula in compression zone for mild steel bars only. And sigma s 0.7 fy will be taken in LSM method only. For WSM the value will be different, so we are going to talk about only LSM method here. So we are using 0.7 fy value. Okay, so if mild bar is replaced by HYSD bars, so the value will be increased by 60%. So 60% of 4 will be 1.6. So the value for development will come as 0.7 fy divided by 4 into 1.6 into tau bd into diameter bar. Okay, so from this you can calculate the tie of the development length of bar for HYSD and mild steel in tension and compression. Okay, so this will be the formula for HYSD bar. Okay, and this is the formula for bar in compression, that is mild steel bar in compression only. So if mild steel bar is provided in HYSD bar is provided in compression zone, so this 4 will be replaced by 5. Okay, now this is okay. So now we are going with the checks also for the development length required simple support. So it support what a value should be present for the development length. So after calculating the development length by this formula, so we have to go with all these checks to just clarify that all the requirement at simple support for development length will be passes. It is present in IS code 456. Okay, so m1 by b plus l0 will be greater than or equal to ld. So ld is calculated by this. So here is the formula, and these values should be greater than our ld calculated at support. Okay, for m1 the formula for the calculation of m1 will be 0.7 fy into st1. st1 is the area of steel at the support, that is half of our mid steel. Okay, in bracket d minus 0.416 into xq, and xq will be calculated at 0.7 fy into st1 divided by 0.33 fck into b, and b is the width of the support. Okay, तो शेयर फोर्स, तो दिस विल बी द शेयर फोर्स एट्रैक्शन, नेक्स्ट विल बी द डेप्थ ऑफ न्यूट्रल एक्सियल सपोर्ट, ओके, एंड एस टी विल बी एरिया स्टील एट सपोर्ट, ओके. दिस फॉर्मूला यूज फॉर द डेवलपमेंट लाइन चेक्स एंड दिस वैल्यू शुड बी प्लेस्ड. नाउ फॉर द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एल जीरो, इफ एम वन बाई बी विल बी ग्रेटर दैन एल जीरो, देन यू डोंट हैव टू रिक्वायर टू फाइंड आउट द एल जीरो वैल्यू और एल नॉट वैल्यू, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एल नॉट, ओके. इफ एम एम बाई बी इज ग्रेटर देन और इक्वल टू एल डी, ओके, सो डोंट हैव टू रिक्वायर टू फाइंड द एल जीरो वैल्यू. बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड और मे एज्यूम दैट दिस वैल्यू विल बी लेस देन एल अवर एल डी वैल्यू, सो हाउ टू फाइंड द एल जीरो, ओके, सो दिस विल बी द कैलकुलेशन फॉर एल जीरो, हाउ एल जीरो और एल नॉट इज कैलकुलेटेड. सो एल जीरो इज द सम ऑफ द एंकरेज लाइन बियॉन्ड द सेंटर ऑफ द सपोर्ट, ओके, एंड द इक्विवेलेंट एंकरेज वैल्यू ऑफ एनी हुक, ओके, एट सिंपल सपोर्ट. सो हाउ इट इज फाइंड आई विल शो यू. सो देर इज सम टर्म्स यू हैव टू नो दैट दिस इज अवर सपोर्ट, अज्यूम दैट. सो एल एच बाई टू इज द मिड ऑफ द सपोर्ट, सो फ्रॉम द मिड ऑफ द सपोर्ट एंड एक्स डैश इज अवर साइड कवर, द कवर दैट यू प्रोटेड इन बीम, ओके, एंड एक्स जीरो इज अवर डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द बिगनिंग ऑफ द हुक फ्रॉम द सेंटर लाइन ऑफ सपोर्ट, ओके, सो दिस विल बी द एक्स जीरो. So this is the center line of the support and this is our beginning of our hook, that is turning of our hook. If we are providing the hook, okay, so we can go with two types, either hook or bent, that is 90 degree bent. So if we assume that we are going to provide the hook, so in tension zone it is placed only, okay, in compression it is not required. So for tension zone only, here we will go with the hook, okay, or bent. So we will calculate the L0. So X0 is the starting of the hook, okay, from center line to the start point. So this is the X0. So now, for if assume that you haven't provided any hook, okay, like this. So formula for finding the L0 will be LS by 2, that is without the support divided by 2, this one, and you have to minus the cover if no hook is provided, okay. So if hook is provided, then the value for mild steel will be, if you are using mild steel, then you have to use the value of K as 2, and for HPHT you have to use the value of K as 4. So if we place in the formula, in this formula, okay, so what will be the value? So L0 will be X0 plus 16.5, okay, when you plot the hook, and X0 will be LS divided by 2 minus X dash minus K plus 1.5. So this is K plus 1.5, okay, from the turning point of the hook to the cover, okay, up to the cover or center of the cover. So center of the turning bar. So our formula will be LS by 2 minus X dash minus this one. So X0 will be calculated. Okay. So this will be LS by 2 minus these values. So this will be calculated. And for L0, LS, if place in the formula, LS by 2 minus X dash minus K plus 1.5 plus 16.5. This is the maximum dia of the bar that you have to provide. Okay. So formula will be coming as, for if you using mild steel, then it will, we have to take the value of K as 2. So placing the value of K in this, we will got the L naught value as L as minus divided by 2. Minus X dash plus 13.5. If we are providing the hook, okay, this will be the formula for calculating your L naught. Okay, sorry, this one. And if we are going with the HYHD bars, then we have to use this formula, LS by 2 minus X naught plus 11.5. Okay, because we are taking the value of K as 4. And here, if we provide the bent, that is 90 degree bend, that is straight, जनरली इट इज़ प्रोवाइडेड इन द टेंशन जोन इन स्लैब और बीम फॉर एल डी. सो इट विल बी टर्न लाइक दिस एंड गो स्ट्रेट. सो नो हुक विल बी मेड. सो एल जीरो फॉर दिस विल बी एक्स नॉट प्लस 8 5. ओके सो दिस प्लस दीज वैल्यूज. ओके सो इट विल टेकन एज 8 5. And how this is k plus 1 phi, and from this point to this point, this is 5 plus k phi. Okay, and from this, if it is turning this calculator 4 phi, so we are going to use L0, L0 is equal to Lx0 plus 8 phi, and x0 will be calculated as Ls by 2 minus x dash minus k plus 1 phi. Okay, so x0 will be calculated and l0 will be calculated by the formula ls by 2 minus x phi x dash minus k plus 1 phi. Plus 8 phi. So it will be taken as l0 equal ls by 2 minus x dash plus 7 minus k phi. Okay, so l0 will be calculated by this formula. And for mild steel, the k value will be taken as 2, and for HPG ball, the k value is taken as 4. So, calculation for L0 will be for mild steel, Ls by 2 minus x test plus 5 phi. And phi is the diameter of the bar, always remember. And here for HPG ball, it is plus 3 phi. So, value of M and B, M1 divided by B in the formula that we have taken earlier for the length requirement, temporal support. So M1 by V may be increased by 30% when end of the reaction are confined by compression member. So assume that we are going to take some examples here. So how we are, when we are to increase the value by 30%. So assume that this is the wall and this is the beam. So this is the compression reaction generated from the top. So we have to increase this value by 30%. Similarly, here the condition will appear. Okay, here also you have to increase the value by 30% because it was a simply separated wall. So in this case, you have to increase the value by 30%. That is 1.2. You have to multiply the 1.3 into M1 by V. Okay, assume this is the beam and this is the slab. So no tension reinforcement will be generated below that. So here. Here, if you see here, it is simply supported on wall. So 1.3 will be added or 30% increase due to compression reaction. And if you see this figure, oh, so here simple support is available, but it doesn't confine the end of the reinforcement. Okay, so factor 1.3 will not be applicable in this. So this type of structure, no to convert for factor adding in this formula. Okay, if you see this example, there is a beam and slab. Okay, so here also secondary beam, if you see here, secondary beam is connected to main beam, so tensile reaction is induced and hence factor 1.3 will not be available. So in the end, if you see the tension, tensile force will be induced, so no requirement for adding the 1.3 in the formula. Okay, so these are some of the conditions that you can understand when to add the 1.3 or increase the value by 30% or not. So if it is simply supported to wall, you have to increase the value by 30%. Here if it is beam is added, slab is added downward, so the tensile force that is here, so compression and tension were both reduced, so no, we don't have to use them that increase that 30% by for this value. Here similarly, there is a beam connected to the slab, so tensile reaction induced, so we don't have to add 1.3 or don't have to increase the 30%. Similarly here, we don't have to increase the 30%. So in the case of wall or simply supported, so you have to increase 30%. If you go with the safer value, then you can add 1.3 with all the formulas if you want to go with the safer value. But if it will increase your the factor or the value for the checks, okay, that is not required. So you can go with both of the formula one by one. So that's for simple support. The LD will be less than or equal to 1.3 m1 by b plus L0. So from these checks you can find out whether your LD will be okay for the development length or not, or LD required for that support will be proper or not. Okay, so these are checks that we have to go with during the calculation of development length. Okay, so you can write down in your copy if you want to. Every equation will be provided step by step here, and I have told you how to add the LD L naught value and when to add the L naught value in the formula. Okay, so there is Excel sheet also we have made for the calculation or development length as per LSM. Okay, so all you need to do there is just provide the type of steel that you have provided by HYHD bar or mild steel. If you are going with HYHD bar here, select the HYHD bar, and we are going to also tell the software that what grade you want to take. So I'm going with M20. Okay, so this blue you have to fill by yourself manually, change value. Okay, and this will be the calculated value by Excel. Okay, and what steel you want to you have provided, so you have to provide the grade manually only. So if you are going with HYHD bar or mild steel bar, so if you are going with the mild steel bar, then you can change it to 1.5. But we are going with HYHD bar, then we are taking the 4.15. Okay, so I haven't added the list here because you can go with any grade for HYHD or mild steel. Just that type you have to select, either you are going for mild or HYHD. From that only the formula will be changing. Okay, so our diode bar that we have taken, so what a diode bar we have taken for designing of beam or slab, so we have to provide all these value the same. Okay, so stress will be calculated as per the formula and grade. Okay, here because it will be calculated by your FY, and tau BD will be chosen by your grade directly from the list. So this value will be calculated. So there is one of the criteria for limiting diode bar. So you can also find out the, or just cross verify the dia that minimum you have to take. This was not a compulsory step, but you can also check that minimum other you can take. So if you provide the value in this formula, so you can get. So you can just provide the formula of LD here. Okay, sigma phi, sigma is into phi upon tau, 4 tau or 5 tau, we do whatever you to use in compression or tension. So is equality greater than this formula. So all the value when you will put, the dia bar will value will be calculated. So our value will be calculated 8 mm. So it is just an assumption, or it is just a trick to find out the minimum diode the bar that you are going to use for the slab. So it will come at 8 mm, that will be okay, we have already taken the 8 mm. So it is not a compulsory step, for your verification only, or so you can go with this step. Okay, otherwise you can leave it from. Okay, so now our development length intention will be calculated at 376, and development length in compression will be calculated at 301 mm. So these value will be used inside. If this check will okay, then you can use this. Okay, so now our LD will be calculated. So just change this with mild. See, if you're choosing mild, the value will be increased here, and if you are choosing HYHD bar, then it will be decreased. So it will be according to your type of bar, the formula will be changing. Okay, and also by the grade that you have taken and your steel. Okay, now we can go for checks at supports in tension. So generally these checks will be ordered for tension, it was not necessary in compression. I will write some of the points here. So hooks are provided normally in plain bars in tension. Okay, so these are the normal conditions where you don't have the time to calculate all the values. So you can go with, if you are using plain bar, then you have to provide the hook. Okay, you have to go with the hook. That was a compulsory step. So deformed bar may not be used without end anchorage. That anchorage is the tight point that we are providing at the junction. So anchorage or development end will same. Okay. So this we are considering this is a slab. Okay, this will be the cut section and this is the beam. Okay. So this will go like this. So this is the anchor. Okay. Or 90 degree or hook, whatever you want to say. So deformed bar may be used without the anchor, and if the development length requires certified. So our development length, I have already told you, when our development length will be okay with this position, then you don't have to bend it. That will be also okay. Okay. So now the third point, the hook should always conform to the specification. So how the value of hook is calculated, I have already shown you. I have inserted in this equation also. Okay. An anchorage value of bent shall be taken at 4 times the diameter of the bar, and each 45 bent, so at 45 degree bent we have to increase the diameter by 4 times, so for 90 degree we have taken 8 times, okay, and subjected to maximum of 16 times. So we have taken the formula of 16 times. These are all given in IS code also. If you go and see here, anchoring reinforcement, so deformed bar may be used without end anchorage, okay, here it is, provided development length required is satisfied. Hooks should normally be provided in plain bar intention, okay? And bends and hooks, so how bends and hooks will be provided, the anchorage value of bent and hook will be given here also. You can check from IS code also. Clause 26.2.2.1, okay? So, now, we'll go for Excel. So, these value will be also mentioned here. You can go and check. So, it is generally provided in tension only, okay? So now our checks that we have to make in tension will be, so what value you have to insert? So area of steel that we have calculated at support of slab or beam, whatever you want to say. So support steel will be inserted here. Okay, and shear force at support that we have calculated in our designing will be given here. Okay. If you haven't seen my previous video regarding the one-way slab design, then you can go and check, you can find out how this value will be calculated for slab design. Okay, so you can also get the shear force and bending moment and area still from that Excel sheet also. You can, I will provide the link in the description or end of the video. Okay, so effective depth will be taken as 91 mm in that. Okay, so this value you have to insert, and the width of the support will be 300 mm, so without the beam or support or whatever you want to take on both of the side of the slab or beam. Okay, that is for secondary beam there is a connection for main beam. Okay, so or for main beam there is a connection for column, so that will be called as support. Okay, so now cover of the support that we have taken in that, so you have to mention here also. So now by this value all the equation will be calculated, and depth of neutral has been calculated by itself, and our moment of action will also calculated by itself. Okay, and the here is with other support that a minimum width that should be present there will be 150 by this value, so it will show you okay, that will be okay then to design. If it is not, then you have to just change the tie of the bar. Okay, when you change the die of the bar here, assume that you are going with 10 mm. See, our development is increases, so our width of the support is also increases. Okay, if you don't want to change this, then what you should do, you have to go with grade, sorry, steel, take it at 50. So this value also be changes, so this value should be satisfied. I told you okay, that will be more safer. So width of the beam should not be less than this value. it will show you okay, you don't have any problem in this. So now by this value at our development line at support will be calculated by the formula one, that is we are going to take the normal formula here for support. So it will coming as 362 for tension zone. So this value is less than our development length in tension. So here is the formula that applies M1 by V. Okay. So now what should you do? And this value will be considered as when no kind of compression reaction will be confined here. So 1.3 will not be added in this value. Okay. So this value for use for only that type of supports. Okay. So now, so it will show you not save add L0 value. So now we are going to add L0 in this. Okay. When it is passed, then you don't have required this value. Okay. So when no hook is provided, so L0 will be coming as 125. Okay. And our new development length will support become as 487. So 487 will become greater than 376. This will be safe. So this is a different hooks or bent that shown here. So if this value will not be safe, then you can go with this value. If this value will not be safe, then you can go with this value. Okay. This is a type of bends. So here it is safe that you don't require any bent or hooks. Okay. And when the support is in compression zone, that is simple support on wall. Okay, so we will go with addition of multiplication of M1 by V into 1.3. So it will become safe as value will come here 471. So our development will be 376. So it is less, so it will be safe here. So you don't require any L0 or bent values for this. So not required here at anymore. Okay, so for tension it is calculated, and for compression I have also added all these values. In any case, there is a requirement of hook, so you can also go with the that. Okay, but generally it is not required. So without the support will be required not less than 125. So minimum required will be 125 after providing the cover that you have given here. Okay, so this value will be also okay. So you have to again provide these values. Now we can calculate the development line at support by that same formula for compression. But for compression, your development line will be different as 301. So it will development length is M1 by V will be coming at 362. So it is safe. So you don't require any hook value. See, generally this will happen to you. This is not required. And our code also specifies that no hook or bent will be required for compression zones. Okay, only tension for tension that is required, but in any case it is required, so I have added this. Okay, so here it is safe also without adding the 30% of compression reaction force. So if we added, then value will more increase, then it will also be safe. So both the value will be safe and no hook will be required. Okay, so you can insert in this Excel sheet and you can get that your development length value and also the checks is safe for you or not. So all the value will be shown here and you can, I will provide the link to download this Excel sheet. Okay. So I have told you how to find the development length and checks at simple support for development length. So you can go with this for slab and beam and can find for tension and compression zone the requirement for simple support or development length. Okay, so if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. I will upload a new video every week regarding structure engineering problems. Okay, thank you.